I'm here in the Chilean Atacama Desert, braving the scorching sun, the gusting wind, the lack of oxygen, just to show you this. Looks pretty impressive, and it's not even finished. When it is, it will be the largest telescope dome ever built. It will have a footprint the size of a football pitch and be nearly as high as Big Ben in London. What is a telescope dome anyway? And what will this one behind me do once it's finished? Today, I'm talking about a very special home. You see, just like you and me need a place to live and feel sheltered, so do optical and infrared telescopes, especially if you decide to build them in a place like this. At 3,000 meters above sea level, the site of the ELT, the Extremely Large Telescope, here on Cerro Armazones, is extremely dry and extremely exposed. Not so great for plants, animals, or even humans, but fantastic for an optical telescope. The night skies here are unlike anything I've ever seen before. And that's why ESO is building the world's largest optical infrared telescopes right here in this part of the Atacama Desert. If you look over there, you can see the Very Large Telescope. It's just 23 kilometers away. But we can't build a billion euro telescope with a 39 meter mirror, sophisticated instruments and delicate components, and then just leave it out here, exposed to the elements. So we need to build a home for it too. The problem is the ELT is by design extremely large. So that means its home also needs to be extremely large. The structure here behind me is 80 meters tall, 88 meters wide, and weighs a staggering 6,100 tons. That's as much as 1,000 elephants. So it's less of a cozy home for a little telescope and more of a 21st century Colosseum. As you can see, the top of the structure is spherical, and that is no accident. In fact, the design was tested aerodynamically in a wind tunnel, the same way as you may test cars or planes. Unlike cars or aeroplanes, we don't want this structure flying away. The ELT dome is now designed to withstand wind speeds of up to 170 kilometers an hour. Well, pressure from the wind is one thing, but what about earthquakes? Chile is one of the most earthquake-prone regions in the world, so of course the ELT dome must be seismic-proof. But there's more to the ELT dome than just its size and shape. This thing is built for astronomical perfection. You can't keep a telescope locked inside. This means that the dome needs to be able to open and move in order for the telescope to peek through and track objects as they move across the night sky. In addition to withstanding strong winds and earthquakes, the ELT dome also needs to rotate quickly. Imagine that, a structure the size of a football stadium, rotating within a matter of minutes to an impressive precision, and with minimal vibrations so as to not disturb the telescope and instruments. To optimize astronomical performance, the ELT dome has special windscreens, ventilation systems, and insulation to prevent what is known as dome seeing, the distortion and blurring of an image caused by turbulence in the air inside the dome. This in turn is caused by pockets of air of different temperature or density. The windscreens slow down the incoming wind and also provide for a smooth airflow across the telescope. By the way, did you know that the ELT dome has solar-powered air conditioning? And no, that's not to keep the astronomers and engineers happy, it's to keep the telescope happy. During the day, the dome is cooled to the predicted nighttime air temperature. When the telescope opens in the evening, temperature fluctuations are minimal and the telescope can immediately operate at full capacity. Finally, additional insulating layers help separate the dome from the air and the ground. All of this helps to keep the air inside the dome nice and calm and peaceful. I have to say, I'm completely wowed. What an amazing feat of engineering. Only the best home will do for what will soon be the biggest eye on the sky. Anyways, I'm off to explore this structure some more. When it's completed, it's going to take me about 30 minutes from bottom all the way to the top of the dome. That's about the same as 5 Chasing Starlight episodes. So I invite you to relax, sit back, look at some of our previous episodes, and I'll get moving.